Hello, everybody, and thank you for your precious time and your attention today. I'm pretty excited to follow up on this very nice presentation because it touches exactly my point for today, that each individual vessel is a unique challenge for ABS, and you need to consider each individual vessel for what needs to be done regarding smart functionality. Before I expand on what we're doing today with developing standards and helping define the problem, I would like to briefly introduce what, how ABS operates to those of you that you are not familiar with our work. Addressing any challenge, the first thing is to establish world-recognized technical standards. This is our first battle in taking different conflicting interests around the industry and agreeing in defining something that everybody can work, deliver, plan, and construct. As soon as we have these technical standards published and approved by the industry, then we can actually accept designs based on these standards, and we review these designs against the rules and the standards we have published. That's an independent engineering verification of the design to make sure that the hidden aspects of that designs are well reviewed and approved by an independent party. The third step is to confirm that the construction of the vessel and its systems are in accordance with the pre-approved plans to make sure that everything goes according to our previously approved engineering work. And finally, throughout the lifetime of the vessel and its systems, we verify that it is maintained to the accepted standard. So let's now take a moment and see how a smart ship looks today and what is the status of the industry. I'm pretty sure that Vartzila or any other major vendor can provide several examples like these ones, but I have taken one vessel from Maersk, and we can see in that particular vessel that we have 0.05 seconds of each motion measured at that ship every day. We have 2,800 hardwired sensors to the control system alone, and we have 7,000 monitor channels for situational awareness and alarms. In that particular vessel, 2 GB of binary data are stored to the control system alone each day. So if you ask my professional opinion, I would say the data infrastructure to support SMART functionality is already here. The machine learning algorithms to correlate physical phenomena between different parts of the vessel in real time are being developed as we speak. And the only thing remains is to identify the point in time when smart interconnected equipment will be able to make better safety and performance decisions than the crew can perform today. When this moment comes to pass, we will know as industry that the first milestone towards autonomous operation is here, but not before then. So class services for the data-centric asset becomes now a very big focal point. And if you remember from the previous slide, the first step towards establishing new class services is the establishment of technical standards. Even more so if you consider the source side office or the vendor's office as a natural extension of the vessel operation. In this scenario, technical standards for the communication links, including satellite communication links, needs to be established and verified independently to include these systems as a natural extension of the vessel for remote control processes or real-time remote monitoring applications. So with that in mind, our key considerations in our technical standards are sensors and instrumentation, the correct specifications for the physical physical process you need to digitize. Some of the data analysts in the room may say that an outlier can be rejected, but in our case, an outlier may be a sensor trigger for maintenance, so you need to be aware of the application of the sensor in the particular environment. Also, the onboard data infrastructure and data transmission, you need to take account that the previous designs already invested has been designed for a specific reason and they cannot accommodate additional loads for communication and processing requirements. onboard data processing and data analytics needs to take account the human factors and their time frame to take decisions in real life operations. Onboard system integration, specifically for systems subject to classification, flag state requirements, and other international conventions, needs to be taken account of, because that's a major risk issue for class, and also to mitigate the effect of cyber threats and the data integrity due to the electromagnetic interference on board motor vessels. So these key factors defines a triangle that we are establishing technical requirements, and let's go and see now a bit of what we're doing in this field. The ABS guide for smart notations will come out in the second quarter of 2019. A guide in general includes technical requirements for designs not mandatory for classification, but they can be approached on a case-by-case basis if the owners need to invest in such functionality. The Smart Series contains a guide and a guidance note, and we explain five major smart groups, consider, namely structural health, monitoring health, asset efficiency, operational performance, and crew assistant augmentation. The functional requirements defined in these groups are supported by the technical requirements necessary for the underlying data infrastructure to support their functionality. And on top of that, we are defining the verification and validation principles our engineers and surveyors will follow to verify independently that this functionality is as per the advertisement. For higher risk designs, we have already established the ABS Cyber Safety Series of technical publications and the ABS Software Series for technical publications that we are going to use to review and approve higher risk smart functionality on board. So what can you expect in the guide? You can expect an expansion of the goal-based standard established in the guidance notes to cover functional requirements of the two major groups defined before, structural health and monitoring health, and machinery health, excuse me. You can expect an expansion of the risk-based approach to cover technical requirements for the underlying data infrastructure, and also you can expect three new notations coming out from ABS regarding SMART, the SMART Ready notation, which will be provide a recognition to any industry third party that the underlying data infrastructure can share with a good performance and good safety resources for communications and data and processing. The SMART Machinery Health Monitoring that will be applicable to a single equipment on board and will provide technical recognition of that particular equipment monitoring and assess their condition against a physical signal-based model or a hybrid model for predictive maintenance actions. And that leads also to easier recognition to third-party service providers on predictive maintenance towards ABS operations on certifying the vessel and reviewing the condition. And similarly, for the structural health monitoring, will be on the same aspects, providing recognition to third parties that that vessel has been monitored and providing predictive maintenance solutions based on a tier level of modeling, standard starting from a single structural model up to a digital live twin. So very briefly, for the companies that are not really into looking machinery health monitoring and structural health monitoring at the moment, we are providing the goal-based framework where they can explore and define their particular problem for a particular vessel, defining the goals, and then defining the functional requirements for these goals, the technical requirements, and the necessary validation and verification activities that will be provided independently by ABS to certify the risk of that design. The independent validation and verification risk assessment we are offering is based on the technical requirements we are going to publish in the guide, and these are selected by the risk matrix of the SMART functionality. The risk matrix is defined by the likelihood of the SMART functionality failure against the consequence of that SMART functionality failure to the operations of the company. As you understand, the higher the risk matrix, the more detailed our plan review engineer will be to cover all influencing factors of several system properties on board, namely the system safety, the dependability, the performance, the functionality, and the operability. Finally, and I would like to conclude with that, we have already taken steps to define the various implementation stages of smart functionality and the various roles along the way. So as you can see, the first step, as I said before, is defining the specific goals for your specific problem. You need to understand the problem before you actually adapt a solution. And we can help there in supporting vendors or the team of vendors that you are considering in helping you define your goals for that particular vessel. Then with the vendors, we can support you defining the functional requirements you need for that particular implementation of that vessel, and moving forward to review independently the technical specification provided as a solution by the vendor to your defined functional requirements. Having passed that stage, we can actually provide the verification of the system being implemented as per plans through the support of the yard or the vendor, and finally to verify that throughout the life cycle of the vessel, the vendor will maintain and upgrade the system according to the approved plans. So that's all from me. The point I want to make is you need to adapt and understand the problem, the specific problem of each individual vessel before you start, you know, exploring solutions for that problem. And we are here to help you doing that. Thank you very much.
Thank you.